This is Mike McCarthy from Front Office Sports, and welcome to another edition of Shot Callers. We're thrilled to have Mike Greenberg of ESPN joining us. You know Greeny as the host of the Get Up Morning Show.
Thank you. Thanks very much for having me.
Mike, talk about expanding the show. I mean, when they came to you and said, hey, Greeny, you want to do double duty, a doubleheader? How did you react?
Am I allowed to use a slight profanity? Because my answer was, hell yes. I hope that's suitable. But absolutely. I mean, it's a fabulous opportunity for us. You know, when you work in one day part, which I've basically done now for 20 years, getting exposure for us, for the show, for what we're doing at a different time of day, I think is really healthy.
How great a job has the league done, Greeny, at turning NBA into a 24/7 sport where the players are literally one-word brands and we care about it every single day, 365 days a year?
They're really smart. And I think that part of it, I mean, sometimes I've said many times that you cannot overlook the significance of luck and good fortune. How much of it was foresight on the part, and I have nothing but the utmost respect for David Stern, who is a person that I've interviewed a million times and I think was a genius and a visionary. How much did he foresee the direction that society was going to go? I can't tell you. He recognized in the early 80s, we need to build a brand and a league on stars. On the star power of Larry Bird, Magic Johnson, and then subsequently Michael Jordan, and we all saw what happened, and the explosion of popularity of the league. What I don't know if he foresaw, or if this was just fortuitous happenstance for the NBA, is that the culture has moved to where that's almost all that matters now. And we live in the ultimate star-driven culture. We make stars out of people quite easily. People are fascinated by the stars' lives. People are fascinated by celebrity. People are fascinated. You and I are old enough to remember a show called Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous. Every show is Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous now. Reality TV is what people are watching now. And that's what the NBA has become. They're a collection of extraordinarily famous people, most of whom fans love, some of whom fans hate, but all of whom fans know and care about. And that's something that all the other sports are envious of and would trade places with. Basketball is not the powerhouse in our culture that pro football is, but basketball has created a niche for itself domestically and globally based upon the star power of its biggest names, and that extends a long way. I would guess you're probably 30, 40 basketball players that people all over the world know intimately.
Let's talk about Get Up. It had a bit of a rocky start. You had trouble drawing viewers and the chemistry wasn't there as you sort of mixed and matched. And when did you feel like you'd finally like gotten it together?
You know, I didn't view it that way so much. Like when we started, they come to you and they say, here, Greeny, go figure out what American sports fans want to see on TV in the morning that's at least a little bit different from anything else that's already on. The truth is, that's just not that obvious. Like, it sounds obvious. They said that to me, and I said, oh, sure, no problem, I got you. And then you put together a bunch of really smart people in a room, and you start trying to think of what that is, and all you're really making are educated guesses. And some of it we got right, and some of it we got wrong. And so it was evident immediately, and that it did not come as a surprise to me at all, that we would be adapting and adjusting it as we went, and evolving it as we went. So I didn't think that that happened more slowly than I was expecting. I think if there's one thing that we launched with, it was the idea that we would be a little more of a morning show, like sort of a full service morning show that people wanted, a little pop culture. And mixed in with the sports. And the immediate reaction I felt from our audience was, no, we want you to do sports. Like that I think was the single biggest thing that we had to adjust. And I think we did almost immediately. I think we figured that out and we started doing that almost immediately. So I think we had it pretty close to right from the start. I think shortening it from 3 hours to 2 hours in retrospect was the right, 100% the right thing to do. And I think it took us a few months to sort of get it to where I felt, okay, I know every single day when we come in the morning what it is we're going to try to do today, which I think was normal. We had Seth Meyers here the very first week that we went on, and I asked him, when you launched your new show at night, how long did it take you before you felt like you really knew what you wanted to be? That's really the hardest part of this, is figuring out exactly what you're trying to accomplish. What is it we want to be? And Seth said to me, It took me about 2 years to sort of figure out, okay, this is what works. This is what makes me comfortable, what the audience seems to want, and most importantly, what we can execute. Like, it's all well and good to want to be something, but you need to be able to do it. So if that's the standard, then I would say, I don't know, something in the neighborhood of 6 months after we started, I felt like, okay, this is a good formula. This seems to be working. The audience seems to be reacting to it favorably. I like it, the staff likes it, and I think we can do it.
I've written and tweeted that I think Rex Ryan has actually done his best work for ESPN on your show. I love his Monday morning quarterback segments with you. I learned a lot, you know, him being an ex-coach, and he's funny and he's entertaining. Is that the job of a host like yourself to be a point guard, to dish the ball and make everybody around you look better?
Take Stephen A. Smith, for example. Stephen A. Smith is an opinionist and he is a performer of unparalleled talent. You put him in a room, just sit him down and let him go. And people want to hear what he says and they want to watch him, and he's just going to be great. That's what he does. He's the best at it. What I do is totally different. How good I am is really going to be dependent on the people you put around me, because my job is to make you, like you're hosting this conversation right now, but if I were hosting it, my job would be to bring out the very best version of Mike McCarthy of which you are capable. That's what I do. That's what a host does. So whether you give me Jalen Rose or Marcus Spears or Jay Williams or Richard Jefferson or Bobby Carpenter, it doesn't matter, Dan Orlovsky, Rex Ryan. If I'm doing my job well, then they're going to go to the places where they are most comfortable, where they have the most expertise, and we're going to keep them away from places that are they are least comfortable. So that is exactly the job of a host.
Moving forward, you've stressed to your folks and your staff that you want this show to be nimble, that if something happens, like Kevin Durant signing with the Knicks, you got to stop on a dime and do the whole show that day about that subject. Explain that a little bit.
Nimble is the most important word, in my opinion. When you're live, you better, in my opinion, today, and with what people expect from a broadcast today, you better be ready to do a lot of different stuff, because there are many days when we will have a plan. We meet a couple hours before we go on the air. We have the best laid plans of mice and men, right? We sit, you're going to do this, you're going to do this. We're going to run this highlight, and we're going to show this video, and you're going to say that, and I'm going to bring this up, and it's going to be great. And then 10 minutes before you go on, Kevin Durant announces he's signing with the Knicks, or whatever it may be. And then we take all of that and you just rip it up and you start over completely and you're doing something else entirely. And in my opinion, whenever Kevin Durant announces where he's going, or Kawhi Leonard or Kyrie Irving or any of these top level stars, if I'm the viewer and I put on ESPN, I want them to be talking about that.